Hi and hello everyone, welcome to our chapter Animal Kingdom. Here we are discussing the portion phylum Chordata. In previous session we discussed invertebrata group. Okay, invertebrata group contain 10 phylums. The 10 phylums are phylum, first phylum Porifera. Then the second one Coelenterata otherwise known as Cnidaria. Then third one Ctenophora. Fourth one Platyhelminthes. Okay, and the next one Eshelminthes. Sixth one Annelida. Then the seventh one Arthropoda. Then eighth one Mollusca. Then the ninth one Echinodermata. And the tenth one is Hemichordata. Okay, Hemichordata means it have both the features of the Chordata and the non-Chordata. Next we are discussing the next phylum, that is Chordata. So here the organism having notochord, that's why their name is Chordata. C-H-O-R, that chord, C-H-O-R-D-A, Chorda, that means chord, they're having notochord. So a stiff, flexible, rod-like structure along the back of animal. This group of animal having a flexible, stiff, then the rod-like structure along the back of the animal. The phylum comprises about 55,000 species. Okay, the main or important characters of this group is the presence of the notochord. Okay, next we are discussing what are the main or the main general characters of the phylum Chordata. First one is organ system of level of organization. That means that organisms contain different types of organ system. That means digestive system, respiratory system, excretory system, like that. Then triploblastic means they're having three germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm and the mesoderm. Then they have coelomate means they have coelom. Then the next one is bilateral symmetry means the organism's body having two equal, when you cut the organism body into two equal halves. Okay, we are getting the right side and the left side as equal. That is bilateral symmetry. The presence of notochord either throughout or during embryonic life. Then the single dorsal hollow nerve cord, usually differentiated into brain and spinal cord. So through the notochord, the nerve cord is passing. Then paired pharyngeal gill slits or pharyngeal cleft. Okay, paired pharyngeal cleft will be seeing. Then post-anal tail extends posteriorly beyond the anus. Post-anal tail. Okay, so the group Chordata, the organism in the Chordata having post-anal tail. But all the organism in the Chordata have not tail. Excretory organs comprise kidney. Then the closed circulatory system. Okay, ventral heart. Ventral portion means where your mouth is seeing, that portion is ventral. So our heart is seen in the ventral side. Okay, and the blood contains RBC. Sexes are separate with rare exceptions. Clear it is. Again, I am repeating the features of the phylum Chordata. The main features are having the dorsal nerve cord. Okay, then the presence of pharyngeal cleft. Then the group having the dorsal tubular nerve cord. Clear it is. So this group, phylum Chordata, subdivided into three groups. Urochordata, Cephalochordata, Vertebrata. The group, the phylum Chordata, again classified into three subphylum. The three subphylums are Urochordata, Cephalochordata and the Vertebrata. Okay, so first one we are discussing, that is Urochordata. Uro means uro, tail portion. That means that the notochord is restricted to the tail region of the larva and disappears in the adult. Clear it is. The notochord which is seeing only in the larval form. Okay. In the larval form, the notochord is in which portion? tail portion, but in case of adult it will be disappear. Example for that groupers, or the example for the urochordata, that is Ascidia, Ascidia. Ascidia is an example for urochordata. Clear? Then the next one is cephalochordata. Cephalochordata. So the notochord extend throughout the length of the animal. Urochordata, the notochord seen in which portion? Tail portion. Okay. But in cephalochordata, the notochord extend throughout. Okay. From the head to tail, the notochord is seeing. And the cephalochordata is a fish-like marine animal. Example for the group cephalochordata, that is Amphioxus. Otherwise it is known as branchiostoma. Amphioxus or branchiostoma. Okay. It is compulsory to read the textbook, NCERT biology textbook. So urochordata means the notochord portion seen in the tail portion, and cephalochordata means the notochord extend from the head to the tail. Urochordata and cephalochordata together it is known as protochordate. What is that? Protochordate. Urochordata and the cephalochordata together known as protochordates. And third subphylum, that is vertebrata. So mammals are included in the group vertebrata. So what are the features of vertebrata? Notochord is replaced in adult either wholly or partially by a cartilaginous bony vertebral column. Nammada nattelile appo vertebral column is present, that's why our name is vertebrata. Here the notochord is replaced by the vertebral column, that's why our name is vertebrata. All vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Clear it is? All vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Another two divisions of the chordate, that are urochordata and the cephalochordata. Okay, and the next feature, the main features of the phylum vertebrata, that means they have excretion and osmoregulation takes place through the kidney, and the locomotion with the appendages. Appendages means here the fins or the limbs. Then the special type of sense organs are seen in vertebrata. So just remember what are the characters of human or birds, fish, that are the features of the vertebrata. Clear it is? So the phylum chordata divided into three subphylum, urochordata, cephalochordata and the vertebrata. Okay. Here again I written here just recent. So urochordata, notochord is present only in larval tail. Dolichium, Ascidia, Headmania are the example. Cephalochordata, notochord extend from head to tail. Example for this group is branchiostoma is the example. The next one is vertebrata. Cephalization means the well-developed head. Okay, well-developed head. We studied uncephalization in echinodermata. Echinodermata comprises starfish. Starfish have that head-like portion. Okay, so cephalization, the head portion, developed head portion will be seen in the group vertebrata with special sense organs. And they have ventral muscular heart. Our heart is made up of muscles. Then excretion and the osmoregulation with help of kidney. Locomotion with paired appendages. Locomotion occurs with the help of paired appendages. Paired appendages, it may be a fin or the limbs. Understood? I hope all you are understand with all these. Then the next that we are discussing, that is vertebrata. Vertebrata is a part of chordata, again divided into two groups. That one is agnatha and the next one is gnathostomata. All the terms are new to you, so don't be panic or don't be confused. Read the text very well and write down this time, this name one or two times. Okay, then you will be familiar with this all the terms. Okay, so vertebrata again divided into two types, agnatha and the gnathostomata. Agnatha, agnatha means jawless, taadi portion le taadi illa adu illathadana endu agnatha. Then the gnathostomata, they have the jaw. So vertebrata classified into two types, agnatha and the gnathostomata. Okay, then agnatha again divided into the division agnatha. So these are the subphylum. Chordata is the phylum and the vertebrata is the subphylum, and agnatha and agnathostomata, that are the divisions. Okay, so the division having a class, that is cyclostomata. Cyclostomata and the gnathostomata have the classes, the classes Pisces and the tetrapoda. Pisces and tetrapoda. Okay,